And the subject I choose is about feet coordination, feet dimensions, that in our days, when we speak with my colleagues, we miss a lot of that subject, the Latin American dancing.
From Spain, Mr. Siscu Pérez.
Good morning, everybody. Thank you very much, Werner, for the introduction. So first of all, I would like to thanks to Assis and Werner to give me the opportunity to be here and lecture for you today. I got a big pressure because it's the first time, of course, and also after the amazing and calm lecture from Lasse, so the earthquake is coming. It was quite difficult to pick up a subject in Latin American dances, because now the way everybody is doing the lectures, talking very much about rhythms, talking about body actions, and about impacts and choreographies. And I would like to speak today about one subject that for me I think is quite important in our days, you to listen. And I also feel quite a different level of quality between the ballroom and the Latin dances. And this subject are the feet and the legs. So when I speak with my colleagues to do the lecture today here, and of course I ask for their opinion, especially to the big maestros, but also were my teachers, I asked them about opinion, and of course everybody was supporting. Yeah, everybody was telling that feet is in the Latin American dances some subject that we forget today. Of course, when I telling you feet, for what we use them, it's not just to do a footwork, it's not just to place them on the floor. So feet give me the support of my body. The feet is the part of my body that I use to talk with the floor, and that I use also to express. If I have to find a part also in the body which is related of the feet, will be the hands. And I need them really to be focused on how I use them and how I work. So my idea today for the lecture was to speak about the dimensions of the feet. So we have not only three dimensions in the body, we have not only three dimensions in what I create in my space. I have three dimensions also in the foot. So I have the under part and the upper part of the foot. I have the inside and the outside edge of the foot. And also I have a front part and a back part of the foot. And what I see in competitions today, and that is normal because it's how the system developed. So the couples are more asked to be more dynamic, to have more fast choreographies, and the competition is like that. But still, the dancers, I think more the dancers than the teachers, because when I speak with my colleagues, we have quite clear what is the idea of what we have to teach. I would like you, after my lecture today, you have a little bit in your brain, yes? A little bit of space to focus on your practice. Also, if you are teachers here, or if some of you are judges, to have a little bit of space in your brain to keep for the feet. And that means that when I do a footwork, I need to give a meaning of that. So how I will use these three dimensions I mentioned before, and we will go through that. You really believe and you really concentrate on work in that. Because at the end of the day, everything that happens in your body, it's supported by your feet. So to go through all my ideas, I will invite a demonstration couple that I asked them to help in my lecture today. They are Marek and Nastia. Big applause for them, please. Thank you. So we prepare a little bit of simple routine into a basic actions we have to talk about these three different dimensions. So I will ask them to show the small routine we create. I will count, and then we will go through that all these parts. And two and three and four, one 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 and two and three and four, one. Thank you very much. So the first thing I ask them to prepare and to be focused on the simple routine, it was about the closing of the feet. When I think about close of feet, it means that not only, for example, in the first action, not only the right foot will close to the left foot. So it means that also the left foot, which is the standing foot I have on the floor, the foot who supports my body weight, will prepare an action to close both feet together. Yeah? And what I want to focus on the first demonstration, it's that we have a front and a backward part of the foot. And when the free leg is coming to the standing, is coming to the standing foot, it means that the heel from the standing foot should be already prepared, and I should lift it to bring the other foot. Can you do it? And then I transfer the body weight into the right foot. So it is very important. And what I see, of course, we have today in the audience also a high top competitors. And I'm talking not only for you, I'm talking to everybody, teachers, seniors, juniors, and judges. What I see very often is that the free leg, it's moving without the preparation in the supporting leg. And of course, under the leg, we have the feet. So if we talk about the front and backward dimension, yeah, it should be a very soft coordination and very, I don't know the word in English, a very take care about that footwork together, and not only to close the foot and transfer the weight. So it means that to close the right foot, I need to lift the back part of the standing foot to have a nice coordination. Then to land the right foot, I need to also lift the other one at the same time. And that soft coordination, that the one who we miss, all the judges, we talk about this, and all the teachers as well. So let's go through that idea, and then I will stop you when I see that I need to do it. So for me, it's very important that the closing of the feet and the transferring on place, I'm really take care in two ideas. So how I place my ball of the foot and how I land with my heel on the floor in a softly touching of the heel. And sometimes what also I see, to do a body action or body compressions especially, if I see a beginner dancers, the compression become external. And that of course is a mistake, because I need to use my gravity in the body as much as inside I can do it, and not in external way. So if I start to push my body weight down to the to the flow and I do it externally, then the feet become heavy, blocked completely, and are not free enough to give me the opportunity to push my body weight from foot to foot or to create a light movement or a big movement forward. So we go through the small routine, thinking about this back and front part of the foot and about the nice and soft coordination between both feet. We do it very slow motion and two and three and four and one and two and three and four and one and two and three and four and one and two and three and four and one. Thank you. Then, not only important the way that I close my feet, also I find very important, and the couples forget to dance about this, when you have a backward walk, I start with the ball of the foot going back. And then what I see very often is that the placement of the foot is completely with the toe turn out. And that position of the backward foot doesn't allow me to transfer my body weight back and to travel with my ankle and my leg inside the foot. If I want to do a backward action and I open the foot directly, of course I cannot track the foot. And that is a mistake I see very often. So the most important is when you go back that you are really able to make the difference between step on the ball of the foot and transfer in the direction to the heel. So we'll be in that more idea. And again, I have this soft contact of the heel going into the backward direction and not that idea. Yes, can we see after the check forward walk? And then we continue. Yep. Yeah, we do the check forward walk and then we go back. Two and a three and a four. So in that moment, I ask them really to have the straight foot back. Of course, should be with a naturally toe turn out, but not really open feet. That is what I see a lot in the dance floor. Thank you very much. So what I want to make you understand is that we got Latin dancers only for the package, only for the presentation, and only for, let's say, the pictures. And again, I'm talking generally, of course. It's about the amount of the couples we have that we are seeing this more and more. What I would like to ask them to dance one more time, that a tracking of the foot and the direction of the foot is very important to have enough space around my body that I can travel and I can transfer. So let's go again from the beginning. And two and three and four and one 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 and two, three and four, one and two and three and four. Thank you very much. Then we already talked about the front and the backward of the foot. Now we're going to talk about the external and internal edge. So from the right to the left dimension. And the idea, if my hands are my feet, yes, I got the internal edge or the internal arch of the foot, yes, to give me the support of my body, and I got the external edge of the foot to give me the direction of the movement. So I will think about that my feet give me these two ideas as well. Not only the coordination about the back and the front of the foot, but as well about the direction and the supporting of my body weight inside. And again, I talk about the mistake to open the toes so much that if I have these two directions in the feet, then I cannot find two different directions. For example, if I go back, yes, again, this will be my direction, or that will be my direction. If I want to really travel back, I need to keep the external part, which it keeps me tracking, will help me to move back. And on the closing of the feet, as we speak in the beginning of the lecture, I can close in the same direction the feet. So then my two legs are on the same tracking and my two legs are on the same direction. So I can travel much easier. Yeah? We will try to show them the same idea, the same choreography we did before, but thinking now about the external part of the foot, give me the direction of the movement, and the internal part of the feet, give me the support of my body weight. We do, again, very slow motion, and two, and three, and four, and one, and two, and three, and we stop here. So now what they are doing in the transferring of the weight, they are trying to transfer their body weight into the direction of the foot. And then when they got the rotation for the next action, then they will use the internal part of the foot to support their body weight. Then always we get a flexible movement, a deepness in the transferring, and also we get verticality, because the feet we use for different things, not just for one. We just place the foot on the floor. And we continue from here. And two, and three, and four, and one, and two, and three, and four, and one, and two, and three, and four, tracking forward, and two, and three, and tracking back, and two, and three, and four, and one, and two, and three, and four, and one. Thank you very much. So I know that that idea is quite maybe difficult to think about, because the mistake it can fall into it is that when I'm thinking in the external part of the foot to tracking in the direction, the feeling when you will try, it can be that the feet are a bit, let's say, turned in, yeah? But remember what I say, that the inside edge of the foot is the one who give me the support. And also, when I see that the dancers are trying to do a lot of body actions on the normal timing, yeah? Because of the position of the foot, the body weight, it's going into the external part of the foot. And that is really a bad mistake, because when you are experiencing it, you lose the balance. Your body is not really vertical inside your body connections. You are all the time traveling just on the externals. What I say before, when I see a compressions, it becomes externally in the body, and my body structure need to be to support my body and to support my picture. Then the inside connections or the inside edge of the foot that support my body weight need to be to find that connections and to work in my body to find the directions I want to change. You follow? Yeah? Okay. And then we got into the third idea that will be the under part of the foot, so the third dimension, yeah? The under part of the foot and the upper part of the foot. So the idea will be that when I want to departure from one foot to another one, I need to feel that between my foot and the floor, I got a really the maximum space possible, depending on the flexibility of the foot, of course. Yeah, and then the foot would receive the body weight. I will try to do the same idea. So first of all, I need to really lift it from the floor, and then the upper part will try to push down to receive the body weight. Then the feeling of the 2 feet will be a little bit like absorbing, or like when we have a pillow, yes, high pillow, and you put your head there. So the pillow is absorbing your body. And what I see, or your head, what I see when you use the feet, it's somehow very stiff when you go into the next step. And the idea will be like also relate in relationship of the first idea. If I use the two, front and the back part, and there is this soft coordination about departure and landing, yeah? But I transfer to the upper and the down part, it's much easier to find the gravity, because I can press a lot or I can push a lot, much more than if I'm not thinking about it. So we will go through the third idea, the third dimension, which is to lift as much as I can. But of course, in the body, in the inside of the body, still I need to feel that I have this down pressure to the floor. So with that idea of the feet, I don't want that the body weight is going out of the floor. So the idea is when I lift it, I really need to think that my center is compressing down to the leg. Then still I feel the gravity, but my feet are really coordinate into that idea that is going up and down. So, again, in the very slow motion, and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2, and I land and I press to the floor and press and press and press and 1 and 2 and press back and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and I press with the right, left and right foot, and with the left, right, and left. Thank you very much. Mare ganastia. So now we will go into the their choreography. Yes, thinking about these three ideas, and let's try if we can get it in a more successful way. So the first thing I want to ask them, it was the first dimension, which was the coordination between the backward part of the foot and the front part. So about the heel up and ball down. And 2, you will count or you will dance?
Slow motion.
So, Nastya has a forward walk here, with the interpretation of the sliding of the foot, and before she move, she need to prepare the backward foot to going up. Then that will be the coordination of movement. Good. Continue. Then Marek has a transferring of the weight on the right foot, and he also will try to think about the left foot is pushing up at the same time that the right foot is going down. Then we got the spiral, and then I will ask Nastya to do the same. So before of the departure of the forward leg, she has to lift lift the backward foot into the softly coordination. Then they got the Cuban rocks, and that it can be a different interpretation because they got, let's repeat one more, because the, Marek got the two heels on the floor. Even you got the two heels on the floor, we talk about the soft touching of the heel. And it means that in the transferring of the body weight from foot to foot, he need to feel that the body weight is going out of the heel and receiving in the ball of the next foot. Can you do just the Cuban rock action, eh? Thank you. Thank you very much. Then, in the twisting, when you have the twist of the feet, nasty, in front of him, you will be in front of him, yeah, facing him. So, now also we can find here this idea of the coordination between the heel that touches the floor and the heel who goes. So it will be like I receive and I leave from one foot to other with this kind of coordination. Then she got the backward walk and the same idea. And again we have the twisting and we go up and down with the heel with a soft coordination. Good. Done? Okay. And then we can go through the same idea, which is, but it was.
You are 6 minutes over the time.
But they got, it was late, Lasse, yeah? Okay, I still have 3 minutes, yes? Thank you. Sorry, Lasse. So then we go into the, we run after that. We go into the second idea of the dimension, which is, the direction of the external part of the foot and the supporting of the internal part of the foot. What's the routine? So it means that on the movement, even on the standing foot, Nastya will try to close the foot to track into the direction, and then the movement is a bit deeper than it was before. Also in the spiral, just a moment. So she plays the foot turn out, and that's quite okay, but then on the preparing for the movement, she needs to work with the external part on the direction. Also now here. So also in the twist, you see, the external part give all the time the direction for the movement. Eh? And if we go now, thank you very much. If we go now, if we go now into the third idea, and the last one, we take just the twist, yeah, the twist. So it's to be focused that the free leg, it's lift as maximum as possible. So then she will press up and down with the upper part of the arch to get the gravity of the transferring. Yeah. Then the movement looks much softer, much more absorbed, and more controlled. Super, thank you very much. And to finish the lecture, we will have a little bit of their rumba with the music this time to enjoy about the three dimensions of the feet we talked today.